Hello students, how are you? I hope you are doing well. So today we are going to study chapter 2, components of food. Let's start this class. So when you eat food in the breakfast, lunch, snacks and dinner, what do you eat? So generally when we talk about meal, so our Indian meal consists of, you know, rice, chapati, dal and some vegetables. And our meals usually have at least one item made of some kind of grain, that is rice and wheat. And other items which we eat are curd, dal, butter, buttermilk and pickles. So what do you eat in breakfast, lunch, snacks and dinner? Think about it. So here, these are the common meals of different regions and states. So we are going to compare what is the variety of food people are eating in different states. So if you take Punjab, Andhra Pradesh and Tamil Nadu, can you see that they will have similar food or different variety of food? So if you see Punjab, they are eating makki ki roti, that is corn. But Andhra Pradesh and Tamil Nadu, they are having rice. What about dal? They are taking rajma, but Andhra Pradesh, people of Andhra Pradesh, they like rasam, tuar dal. And same with Tamil Nadu, which is not written over here. And vegetables, they like sarso, that is mustard leaf curry. And in Tamil Nadu, they like potato. And apart from the main food, they like to have curd and ghee. In Tamil Nadu, it is sambar, which they like to prefer. In Andhra Pradesh, you can see they like to have buttermilk, ghee, pickles, etc. So this table you have to complete in your book, which is given. So you have to write about different other states. If you belong to Rajasthan, you write about your choice of food. If you are from Gujarat, you write about that. If you are from Maharashtra, Bihar, Bengal and other Andhra Pradesh, you write about what do you like. Okay. So here, what are nutrients? So the ingredients which are present in food items, they are actually needed by our body. So these components which are very much needed by our body are called nutrients. So what are major nutrients of body? So you have to remember all these things. First one, carbohydrates, fats, proteins, minerals, water, roughage and vitamins. Can you remember? I think you have drawn this flowchart in your notebook, isn't it? And now you can see there are a variety of food items, vegetables, cereals, pulses, fruits. So can you guess which food item is rich in carbohydrate? Which food item is rich in protein? I think we cannot guess it. It's difficult. So let's study about the different food groups. So generally food group, it is divided into three categories. One is bodybuilding food, protective food, energy giving food. Okay, so proteins come under bodybuilding foods, protective foods they come under minerals and vitamins, and energy giving food are carbohydrates and fats. So can you see the example? So you can see milk, pulses, they come under protein. Fruits and vegetables, they come under minerals and vitamins. And cereals, fats, sugar, rice, potato, all these things, they come under carbohydrates. Okay. Now, this slide is very, very important. We are going to classify different types of food. And then we will be learning about the sources. And very importantly, we are going to learn about the function. So let's see here. Energy giving foods are carbohydrates and fats. I think you just learned previously. So what are the sources of carbohydrates? You have to remember it. Rice, potato, wheat, sugar. So are you taking rice and potato daily? That means you are having carbohydrate daily and they will provide lot of energy. So you imagine after you have rice, wheat, or that chapati, you feel, you know, running here and there, studying, doing lot of work. That means you are having some energy. Now, these fats, what are the sources? Butter, ghee, milk and cheese. So these fats, they give double energy, more energy as compared to carbohydrates. That does not mean that we have to eat fat rich food in more amount. We have to balance it. Now, bodybuilding foods are vitamins and minerals. They are also called as a protective food, and they are the sources are fruits and vegetables. They are required for normal growth and development. Now, proteins, they are also called bodybuilding food, and the sources are milk, egg, meat, fish, soybean, and they help in building and they repair our body. Water. Water is very, very important. You know, when you eat a lot of fruits and vegetables, water content is present in them. That's why, you know, they help in digestion. So we have to drink a lot of water. And fibers. Fibers are also called roughage. Green leafy vegetables, fruits, and whole grains, they are the sources of fibers. And what they do? They help us to get rid of undigested food. Did you understand? So now, these are the food items rich in carbohydrates which you generally eat. I think you love to eat banana, you love to eat chapati, bread, rice, potatoes. These items are rich in carbohydrates. So, foods high in fat. So when you take butter, chocolates, all these contain fat. And vitamins are of different types. So I'm not going to explain in detail, but just we will classify what are the different types of vitamins. So they are vitamin A, vitamin B, vitamin C, vitamin D, and vitamin E, and vitamin K. Okay. So these foods, they are rich in protein like eggs and then meat, fish, and some kind of nuts and seeds, dals, bean. These are rich in protein. So can you see this picture? See, eggs are there, and then pulses, whole grains, meat, fish, all these are rich in protein. So you should be eating these food. And then roughage and dietary fibers, you know, these fruits, vegetables, and whole grains, they are rich source of fiber. So when you eat lot of fiber, so you they will help you to get rid of undigested food. They will, you know, they will give you, they are very important, and they help in the treatment of constipation also, and they are very good. So we should have it. And now you must have heard about minerals. So there are many minerals in our NCERT book. We will be talking about few minerals. So you know, what are the names? Iron, calcium, phosphorus, potassium, iodine, sodium, and fluorine. So these minerals are also present in fruits and vegetables and different food items. So we should be learning later, and you have to remember the names of the minerals. Now, water. So do you drink water daily? How many glasses of water do you drink? Just think about it. So when you drink juice of vegetables and fruits, that means you're already having lot of water content, isn't it? So that's nice. So here, how much water we have to drink? See, they here 8 glasses of water is shown. That means nearly 8 glasses we have to drink in a day. But what about if, you know, if people vary in different body weight? Some are, you know, 40 kg, some are 45 kg, some are 80 kg, some are 100 kg. So I will tell you how much water should you drink every day. So you have to remember, or you have to note down your body weight and just divide it by 8. And that will give you the number of glasses you have to drink every day. So now let's prepare some chemicals. So we have to learn to prepare chemicals. So there are 3 chemicals: iodine solution, copper sulfate solution, caustic soda solution. So in 6th class, we have to learn the names of chemicals, and we also have to learn the formulas. Okay, so how are you going to prepare iodine solution? You have to take iodine powder and you have to dissolve in half filled test tube with water. And how are you going to prepare copper sulfate solution? You have to take 100 ml of water and just dissolve 2 gram of copper sulfate. Same, we will be adding 10 gram of caustic soda in 100 ml of water to prepare caustic soda solution. Now we are going to use these chemicals. So now you can see we are going to do test for starch or carbohydrate. So we'll take potato, we'll cut it into 2 halves, and then by the help of dropper we will take iodine solution and put it some drops on the potato cut, and we will be observing the blue black color. This blue black color will confirm the test for starch and carbohydrate. Now test for protein. So we have taken food item pulses, so we will grind them, mash them, and we will add some water, and then we will add copper sulfate solution which we prepared, and then we will nicely shake it, and then we are going to add caustic soda solution, and after some minutes we will observe beautiful violet color, and it will confirm and show the presence of proteins. Okay, and here the next test, that is test for fats. Generally test for protein and test for carbohydrate we will not be able to do during this online session, but we will be doing when we will come to school. But test for fats you can do at home. This is one activity. So you have to take groundnut or any nuts, and you know, you have to take paper and you have to crush the groundnut with some, you know, stone or some any hard objects, and then you can dry the paper, and then you bring the paper near light or sunlight, you will see some oily patch on the paper. So this confirms the presence of fat. Now this is food pyramid. What are the food items we have to eat more, and what are the food items which we have to eat less? Okay, so these maximum number of star shows that we have to eat these food items more, and less star shows or tells us that we have to eat these food items less, but we have to drink water regularly. So you can check what are the food items you have to eat more and what are the food items you have to take less. Okay, now what is balanced diet? So balanced diet provides all the nutrients that our body needs. So you can see here a balanced plate is including all these things. So can you have rice all the time? If mama, your mother gives you rice in the morning, rice in the afternoon or at night, do you like it? Or if she gives you chapati all 3 times, will you love it? No. So in balanced plate, a balanced diet tells us that we have to eat different nutrients like carbohydrates, proteins, minerals, roughage, fibers, and we have to drink water also. And that will give a balanced health. It will help us to get healthy, and it will protect us from all kind of diseases also. That's all for today. See you next time. Thank you.